Hello everyone, welcome back. In this video, let me discuss about what is JavaScript. First of all, what is JavaScript? Here is the few definitions that we have about JavaScript. What is JavaScript? JavaScript is a programming language that executes on the browser. Here, that means it is a programming language that executes on the browser that doesn't need any server to connect. It turns the static HTML web pages into interactive web pages by dynamically updating content, validating form data, controlling multimedia, animate images, and almost everything else on the web pages. It turns the static HTML web pages into interactive web pages. That means pages are web pages that doesn't change its content until we change it to the content that makes the web pages interactive. First of all, what is interactive? Interactive is allowing a two-way flow of information between computer and computer user, responding to user's input. That is interactive. This JavaScript makes the pages more interactive and dynamically update the content whenever we need it. Here we are having the another definition. JavaScript is a scripting or programming language that allows you to implement complex features on web pages. That allows us to implement more complex features, more interactive way, dynamic way of approach to the web pages. Every time a web page does more than just sit there and display static information for you to look at. Displaying timely content updates, interactive maps, animated 2D, 3D graphics, scrolling video jukeboxes, etc. You can bet that JavaScript is probably involved in it. It is the third layer of the layer cake of standard web technologies. That means it is a third layer, means the first one is HTML and second one is CSS and third one is JavaScript. That means if you want to discuss about this definition, here is the: it is a scripting language that allows us to implement complex features on web pages. Instead of displaying static content, it displays the timely content updates. That means the more way it will dynamically update the content instead of static approach. Static approach means rarely the user has to change the data. The user has to make certain changes like that. That is static content. It displays the timely content updates and interactive user experience. That is this second definition. Here this is the JavaScript frameworks. Here we have Angular, which is a single page application. And the Node.js, Vue.js, and also we have the React, which is a JavaScript library. Here, Node.js is the asynchronous event-driven JavaScript runtime. It uses JavaScript on the server. These are the JavaScript frameworks. And the current JavaScript version is ES12, which was released in June 2021. And also we have the second major release in JavaScript, which is ES6. ES6 was the second major release after JavaScript invention. It has a lot of features that has made significant change in JavaScript. Here we have the JavaScript engines, which is SpiderMonkey, which is from the Mozilla Firefox, and also we have V8 engine, which is from the Google Chrome. Let us see how JavaScript code works internally. Let us look at how JavaScript code works internally. Let's say you write your JavaScript code and we wanted to have some effect, that effect, interactive effect on the web page. Here we write the JavaScript code and we want that effect to be displayed on the web page. In order to run the JavaScript code, here is the JavaScript engine. Either it is the V8 or SpiderMonkey, which is built inside the browser, which is built into the browser. This will read the code and interpret the code line by line and execute the JavaScript code. It is a single threaded approach and it displays the effect on the web page. And this is how JavaScript code works internally. It doesn't compile, and recent times, we are using compilers to display the code, to run the code more efficiently and faster. That's all in this video.